Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO of DBC Technology, and I've got an awesome one today. Today, Unifi is announcing the first phase of their UPS strategy, and they're introducing two new UPSs that I think might be right for you. In my day job at DBC Technology, we put in thousands and thousands of uninterruptible power supplies. Basically, these are battery backups that allow our equipment to run in case there's a power outage or a brownout. We install computers all across the southeastern United States, and invariably, because of the lightning and storm activity in this area, there are a lot of power outages. So for us, most of our equipment has a battery backup attached to it. So personally, I'm very excited to see Unifi get in this market so that we can tie our UPS strategy into our already existing Unifi ecosystem. So what does this phase one rollout look like and how may it fit your needs? So they're gonna have two units in this first rollout. One is gonna be a 2U rack mount unit called the PSU-2U, and the other is gonna be the UPS tower. And like the name says, it's gonna be a tower unit. So the tower unit should be released for sale today, and the 2U rack mount unit will be released next month. So I've got the tower unit here today. We're going to do a full review on it. There's two or three things on the tower unit that I think may make it the ideal tower UPS, but there are also a couple things about it that may make it not right for you. And we'll go through all of that here in the review. I do not have the price on either unit at the time of this filming, but I will overlay it on the screen now, or it'll be in the description down below. I know they're very aggressively pricing these units to be comparable to the other brands in the market. Before we dive into the UPS tower review, I quickly want to go over some of the technical specs of the UPS-2U. It weighs 30 pounds, so obviously it has some heft. It does come with a field replaceable battery. That is awesome. It's got a 10-100 network connection for management. It's got 2 gigabit Ethernet ports that's in and out for surge suppression. That's pretty cool. It's a 1.44 kVA, 1,000 watt capacity. Its runtime at full load is 2.3 minutes and at half load it's 8 minutes. It's got a 6 to 8 hour recovery to 90% capacity. On the unit itself, it doesn't have a typical unified display, but it does have LEDs, and there's a key to what those LED means in the technical specs here. And I'll go over that on the UPS tower. They're a little bit different, but similar on the UPS-2U. So those are the main specs of the UPS-2U. If you want to dive into the details, you can click the link down in the description and it will give you all of the technical specs of that device. So, all right, so let's jump over to the UPS tower, and I'm gonna give my first kudos to the UPS team, and it is for the packaging. I know we run through unboxing every time and I say that Unifi is really good at their packaging, but it cannot be understated how nice it is to have a handle on the outside of a UPS package. By definition, these UPSs are heavy batteries, so to be able to have a simple handle to pick these things up and move them around is not lost on me. Especially for us, we buy these by the dozens, and to be able to grab a couple and just go to the truck with them and not have to struggle with a big gangly box that weighs a lot. I know it's a small feature, but it's a really nice touch. The box opens from the side, which is really nice. You lay the battery on its side, you open it up. It makes it very easy to pick the battery up, and it's a nice ergonomic way to handle a battery. So on the battery itself, on the top, there is an RJ45 connector to connect it back to the network for management. Right next to that is a little pinhole for your tool to do a reset. You'll see there are 10 outlets that are divided into two sides. There's the surge plus battery side and just the surge side. So 5 of the outlets just do surge suppression and 5 of the outlets do surge plus the battery. You'll also notice that the bottom 2 outlets on either side are separated a little bit so that you could put a power brick on there and not interfere with other outlets. And down at the bottom, there is a network surge suppressor, which is nice. It has an in and out, and that's 1 gigabit. And then you have the power cable down at the bottom. It's a very attractive unit. And if you turn it around to the front, there's a little bit of ventilation. There is a power button with an LED surround and 5 LED buttons down below. And it's got the Unifi logo on the front of it. When I set it next to the CyberPower UPS I have been using, it is a very similar size and form factor. It's a little bit taller, but almost identical in the space that it takes up. So that's the device itself. Let's go ahead and get it plugged into the wall, get a few devices plugged into it. Let's get it adopted. And I'm gonna go over a couple of the reasons that I feel like this might be the right UPS for you. All right, so you can see I've got the UPS tower plugged in. It's got an IP address and it's ready to adopt. So I'm gonna go ahead and click to adopt it. And it's going to do its thing. All right, so that's adopted now. And as I mentioned on the UPS-2U, on the front of the UPS tower, there is a little LED that surrounds the power button. And that flashes differently. It started off solid white, meaning it was ready to adopt. As it was adopting, it was flashing blue and white. And when the adoption finished, it is now solid blue. And the 5 LEDs below it are solid blue as well. I'm gonna go really quickly through what some of those status lights mean. And again, this is from the technical specs, which you can get by clicking the link down in the description. So for the status LED, if the light's off, obviously the device is turned off. If it's flashing white, it's initializing slash factory default. If it's steady white, it's waiting for adoption. If it's steady blue, the device is adopted and working. Flashing blue, it's in battery mode. Alternating white and blue, it's the firmware upgrading. Rapidly flashing blue is when it's been put in locate mode. Steady red is a warning. Flashing red means low battery. And the five LEDs below the power buttons, if all five are on, it's 80 to 100%. If it's steady blue on four, it's 60 to 79. If it's three, it's 40 to 59%. If it's steady blue on two, it's 20 to 39%. Steady blue on one, it's 1 to 19%. And if they're all off, it is dead at 0%. A couple quick specs before we jump into it. It is 18 pounds. And this is a 1 kVA 600 watt unit. Under full load, you're going to have 2 minutes of runtime. And under half load, you're going to have 7 minutes of runtime. Again, if you want to geek out on all the specs, click the link down in the description below. They are all there for you. All right, so now that's adopted, let's jump right in the software. You can see here we're on my UCG fiber. We are on network, and it just shows up as another device here. I also mentioned before, if you click the locate button, it will flash the light blue on it. If you had three or four of these in the server closet and you didn't label them correctly, that might help you every once in a while. All right, let's go into the UPS tower. So you can see, so right off the bat, it shows you which switch it's connected to, which port is on that switch. It shows you the different ports and the connected plugs on the device. One thing I will say here that I was expecting is that maybe more of a breakout on these ports. It is showing you information by bank, not by each individual ports. So you can see here power usage and whatnot, but it is on the whole bank of 1 to 5 and 6 to 10, as opposed to being each individual port. Shows you overall power utilization. I'm using 402 of the 600 available watts, 67%. My battery is at 100%. Here you can see the safe shutdown pairing. I have three devices that are available for that: the UNES Pro 8 Home, the UNES 2 Pro, and the UCG Fiber. I can choose any one of those. Now, it does not automatically know that this is that any of these devices are plugged into this unit. For me, the only device here that would make sense to pair is the UNES 2 Home, because it is plugged into this device. The UCG Fiber is in a different room, and the UNES Pro 8 Home is not plugged into this device. It gives you more basic information about the model and firmware, and power usage, and some more networking information. We'll come back here and pair here in a second. We'll go on to insights, and obviously there's not a lot to see here, but if there was any more history there, you would be able to see those insights. And under settings, I could come in here and rename this. I'm gonna leave it as this. I could change my IP settings. This is a really cool feature, and along with the safe shutdown, I think this is a reason that this might be a device for you. I love the way that Unifi has been adopting some open standards lately, and a NutServer is a way for the UPS to share its status with another device and have that shut down gracefully. So use the ID host name and port when configuring third-party devices for safe shutdown. So if I enable NutServer here, I can give it an ID and a port and give it some login credentials, and it will be able to communicate with the UPS. So if the UPS goes on battery, it can tell the non-Unifi device, hey, I'm on battery, and let that gracefully shut itself down. Really nice that they included this. Obviously, this is included on most other brands, but it's great to see that they allowed third-party safe shutdown through that NutServer. It's got the LED on the front. You can turn on and off. You can set a replacement device or load a configuration from another device. So if you got this all set up and you want to replace the battery, you could just set the replacement, or you could load a configuration from another device. You can do a manual firmware update. You can do locate like I did before. You can restart it. You can remote power off, and you can remove. One thing I would like to see here, and this is my one complaint so far, is if you go to the USB strip and I come over to config here, I've got all of the different outlets that I can control individually. And so you can see here, I've got Comcast on one and my living room frame and an outlet and the Nebu and Alexa, and I can manually restart each one of those independently. I think this is a really great feature. I wish that this would be also included on the UPS tower, but at this point it is not. I'm assuming that that is probably a hardware implementation, not something they're going to be able to implement further on down the road in software. But I would love to be able to remotely restart things individually. Very nice feature on the UPS strip. So if you're looking for that, it is not here as of this recording. But let's go down to safe shutdown pairing, and I'm going to set that up on my UNES 2 Home here. I'm going to click to pair. It's going to ask for its credentials, and that quickly, it paired. So that's all there is to it, and it's now paired. I can unpair it. I can also pair multiple devices. So obviously, if there's two Unifi devices here that are plugged into this UPS, I could go ahead and set that up. Also, I could go into NutServer and do a third party with the NutServer as well. Now, if I pull power from the wall to the UPS tower, the UNES 2 Home is going to sense that, and it's going to start its shutdown process. Really cool, super easy, couldn't be any more simple to do that. One other thing I would like to see here, and you're not seeing here it as well, is I would like for my my switching to be able to do the same thing as well. This is really cool. Very simple, very easy. And obviously, this is early days for Unifi UPS power, but I could see this being a very powerful feature moving forward. And there's one more thing about this that's really cool. And obviously, Alarm Manager is being a lot of press lately. For me, I think it's a really great addition to the ecosystem, and it's making the ecosystem be able to expand beyond just Unifi itself. I think this is another thing where having UPS data and be able to do actionable things from that UPS data is really powerful. So I'm going to click create an alarm here. You'll see here we have a category called power. And now I can see insignificant PoE power, which has to do switches, backup power in use. That sounds pretty interesting. UPS overload detected. Sounds pretty interested. Power supply not operational. So backup power in use seems like it would be a really cool one. I'm going to deselect all here, and I'm going to go into the UPS tower, and I'm going to say notify. So if I'm going on backup power, I can just quickly notify all admins, and I could click create. Really cool. So if you wanted to know, hey man, something's super important on this, I want to know every time power is interrupted there, I will get that notification and I can do some actionable item. Or, you know, I could trigger some other thing from that as well. Or I could say UPS overload detected. So maybe there's too much power being drawn on it and it's going to damage UPS. I could also do that. And, you know, I could do a webhook and make this do something else from here. But again, another super powerful way to take something basic like a UPS knowing that is on power and now be able to do some actionable items from there. Obviously, it's like everything else in Alarm Manager, this will be an evolution. It will get more powerful as time goes on. And as Unifi adds more UPS devices to this ecosystem, you can see this getting more and more powerful with more and more options and things that you would be able to do with that information. All right, so let's bring this thing full circle. At the beginning, I said there's two or three things that you're gonna make this super attractive for certain people and some things that are going to make it not perfect for others. First and foremost, for us, this is a very similar device to what we're already putting out there. So for us, it's a no-brainer. We're already using APCs and cyber powers that are basically the same output and wattage, and they are the same price points. But for us, if we use Unifi, we get to add the whole ecosystem of management and reporting and all the other automations that come through using that Unifi ecosystem. But so for us, it's kind of a no-brainer. Same thing for the 2U. We're already putting a similar unit in our racks that's a similar price point. Where this may not make sense for you is if the power that you need is not represented by one of these two units. Obviously, it's very early days for Unifi, and I'd like to see them build this out. But if you need more power or you need less power, we put in a ton of little 600 or 650 VA units out there. I would love to see a smaller unit in that output range or bigger ones that give you more power conditioning and, you know, allow you to power bigger servers and that kind of stuff. But for the most common use case scenarios, I think these two fit the bill. One other thing that I wish they had included on the tower is the ability for me to address each port individually and be able to turn on and off individual items. So like if I had a switch on port two and I wanted to recycle that, I'd be able to just click it like I could on the USB strip. And I really do wish they had that feature. And if you're looking for that feature, this may not be the right thing for you. Also for us, we're in the Southeast United States. We use a lot more UPSs than you would in other regions. I'll throw up a lightning map of the United States right now. If I was in Oregon, I wouldn't use as many UPSs as we do here in Florida and Georgia and South Carolina because our power is typically pretty volatile here. And so we deploy a lot more of these units, and obviously to be able to automate that process of shutting things down, alerting to us when things are out of state is all super important to us. And it may be more important to us in our region than it is to other people, other places. One other thing is that we are going to buy a ton of these, and I think a lot of other professionals are going to buy a ton of these. So I have a feeling this is going to be an item that is in great demand. So if it's something that you do want, I would buy it when you see it available, because I have a feeling they're going to have a little bit of trouble keeping these in stock just because of the popularity and the fact that people will buy these in bulk. So that's my quick review. I will be reviewing the PDU to you when I get my hands on it. So look forward for that. If you have any questions that you want me to answer in that video, please put them down in the comments down below. And anything else you want to know about this particular unit, please put it down there. Also, if you're going to buy these or any Unifi gear, there will be affiliate links down below. Please use those. It helps out the channel. As always, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.